Hi, I'm Dr. Dani Gordon, and welcome to Dr. Dani TV. And this is the Cannabis Wellness Show, where I talk about all things CBD and cannabis medicine. I'm a medical doctor, and I specialize in evidence-based natural medicine, brain wellness, and cannabis medicine, and I've treated thousands of patients with CBD and cannabis medicines, and this is where I share everything I've learned on this topic. In this video, I'm going to talk about cannabis and depression. So cannabis and depression is a really hot topic. It's a controversial topic for many people. And before I started adding cannabis medicines to my own practice, I had a lot of misconceptions myself about cannabis and depression. Over a decade ago, when I was in medical school, we didn't really learn anything about the endocannabinoid system, about cannabis in general, but the things that I did learn were really negative. I was told, you know, people who smoke cannabis will be at bigger risk of depression. It will make their depression and mood disorders worse universally. It didn't really matter what was in the cannabis, whether it was really high CBD, low THC. There was no even distinction in what we were talking about. So there was a lot of fear in the medical community around cannabis of all forms, even CBD around mood disorders and depression in particular. What I found when I started using cannabis medicines in my practice was that I was getting a lot of referrals with patients who suffered with depression. And as most people who have suffered with depression will know, or know someone who has suffered with depression, it's not that depression is just in isolation and everything in their else in their life is amazing. Usually my patients who are suffering with depression also have an element of anxiety with their depression. They sometimes have sleep dysfunction. They oftentimes have chronic pain. They have other things that are going on. So oftentimes depression is part of this bigger picture. And sometimes depression is the final common endpoint for things that have gone wrong in the brain and the body. And it, really the brain is in this withdraw and protect mode, not going out into the world and kind of, you know, approach behavior mode, which we all kind of want to be in to really thrive. And I do a lot of brain stuff as well. And when we look at EEG studies of the brain, when we actually look at the electrical things that are going on in the brain with depression, we have an underactive left frontal lobe with depression. So basically in depression, we really want to wake the brain back up and help people interact with the world in a better way. So this is where cannabis medicines can come in handy, to my initial surprise. So initially when someone comes to me and depression is a main feature of why they're coming to see me, they've usually already tried a gazillion different things for their depression. They've usually already tried things like therapy and CBT, cognitive behavioral therapy. They've tried exercise a lot of times. They've tried lots of drugs. A lot of times they've tried other herbal medicines, and none of it really worked that well. So these are the kinds of patients who come to see me for cannabis medicine. And usually what I do to start them off, someone with depression, is I start out with a CBD oil as a base of their therapy. And I start out with taking the CBD oil in the morning, in the mid-afternoon, or around lunchtime with food always, and then really around like 5 p.m. in the evening. And if that, you know, I usually do that for 4 weeks or so, see how people respond. And if they have sleep dysfunction, which can be a major driver of depression because sleep dysfunction the next day makes the brain more irritable, then sometimes I add in a little bit of THC before they go to bed to help with their sleep in a very, very, very small dose along with more CBD. And then if they're still having trouble with motivation and getting going in the morning, that's when I find that actually a little bit of vaporized cannabis, which contains some THC as well as some CBD, can be very, very helpful, and it has to be the right strain. So with a lot of my patients who suffer with depression and anxious depression or anxiety, and especially my patients who have chronic pain on top of this, it can take them 3 hours to get their day going in the morning. So that really leaves them quite crippled as far as not being able to work, not being able to just do housework or to see their friends or to see family members or take care of their children in the way that they want to. And what we see with when I add cannabis in a vaporized form is it can help wake the nervous system up if it's the right strain and help them get going. So instead of taking 3 hours to get their day going, it can take them 20 minutes. Like most of us without depression just kind of wake up and, you know, get going. So usually what I do there is I would start with a strain that's high in things like D-limonene, these citrusy uplifting terpenes, and a more sativa dominant strain. Again, the genetics get tricky here because everything's kind of a hybrid now, but to keep things simple, really what you can think about it as is using a sativa dominant D-limonene rich strain of cannabis in a vaporizer. And usually I like to combine it with a strain that's high in CBD. So they're not getting that straight up THC. In general, with patients with depression, I try to avoid THC only. I really, really think that adding CBD is very important to keeping the mood stable. And the reason that I do it this way is because there's been lots of studies with CBD in particular as an antipsychotic agent, as a mood balancing agent in people who have mood balance issues. So people with bipolar disorder, for example, people with schizophrenia and psychosis. So that's different than depression, but I still find in my patients that when we use more CBD, a lot of CBD, and then add a little bit of THC in if they need it, is the best way to go with depression. Another really interesting thing I found working with my patients with depression using cannabis medicines is that oftentimes part of the reason that they're having trouble is because they really want to engage with the world. They want to do things like cognitive behavioral therapy. They want to do things like exercise, socially engaging their friends and their family, because we know all those things help with depression. But they have really low brain motivation because their left frontal lobe is underactive and they just can't engage. So basically we can use cannabis medicines as a catalyst. It kind of like is a catalyst to get everything going. So what I do sometimes with patients is I get them to vaporize a little bit of cannabis before they want to go work out or before they want to go for a run. And sometimes even before they want to go out socially and engage with the world. And that can be really helpful to get them going. And the really cool part is that once they get going and they start doing all the other behaviors that are antidepressive naturally, like exercise, getting social, doing CBT, doing therapy, if that's part of their treatment plan, they just get better and better and better. And it's a snowball effect. And then they need less cannabis to help them because those other things start to kind of take hold in the brain. So if you liked this video, please like it, share it with someone who might benefit from it, and leave me a comment. Let me know what your experience has been with mood and cannabis or CBD. And if you want more on cannabis, CBD, evidence-based natural medicine, and brain wellness, please come over to drdannygordon.com and sign up for my free resources.